We are all intrigued by the concept of a perpetual motion machine. If you weren't intrigued by it, you wouldn't be watching this video right now. There are lots of videos on YouTube where people show their perpetual motion machine, and then there are other videos that disprove those machines by finding the trick that's involved. But I came across one I thought was pretty interesting. By Mr. Mark Waller, and the concept behind his takes into account that electrons act differently at a point than they do at a surface. So he had a disk with strips on both sides, and he had two points collecting electrons, basically. The idea is that as this spins around, electrons are moving to the point, not because it's spinning, but because that's how electrons work. But on the other side of this is another strip that would attract the electrons away from the disk. So as it spins, electrons gather at a point, okay? Also guided by these two points here. As it spins around, this other strip on the other side over here disrupts those electrons. So basically it's a push-pull kind of thing. We're pushing and pulling, pushing and pulling. Now I had read an article actually several decades ago about how the first transistor was invented. And it involved dealing with a point also. So here's a graphic of that first transistor. And you can see how it involves a point for gathering these electrons. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna take our model here. We're gonna give it a nudge. And it's working. But I'm not done yet. Start a timer just so that you know there's not any tricks going on with the video here. That's one continuous video. Now there's another website that tries to disprove Mr. Waller's design, and that other person claims that Waller has a fan off camera blowing over the disk, making it turn. So to disprove that concept, I have a glass dome that I'm going to place over the model. And you'll see that it still keeps going.